In my mind, there is absolutely no question that phthalates harm children's health.
We know that food is one of the most common ways that most people are exposed, and we have found that children may be more vulnerable to the adverse health effects of phthalates because their bodies and brains are still developing, especially when they are in utero.
And there's a growing body of research that shows that exposures to phthalates in utero can cause issues with neurodevelopment. It can also cause problems, especially baby boys, with their urogenital tract. So there could be implications for fertility as they get older.
In these studies, we measure exposure to the moms while they're pregnant and then follow the children over time and look to see how their health is impacted.
There are links between the mother's exposures to phthalates and cognitive problems in the children, things like lower IQ, a lot of behavioral problems, so aggression, conduct problems, inattention. The ones that are most concerning to me are the effects on the way the child's brain develops, which is called neurodevelopmental effects.
One thing that we know about phthalates is they don't stay in the products that they're put in, so they easily can migrate out of those products.
Best way to reduce exposure would be to remove phthalates from the processing and manufacturing equipment and materials that contacts the food. It's really difficult for anyone, including myself, to figure out which products would not contain phthalates.
Food companies really have a responsibility to make sure that they're providing safe food to the population, and they need to be conscientious about what packaging materials they're using and what processing equipment that they're using to ensure that it doesn't have phthalates and other harmful chemicals in it that then get into the food.
In traditional toxicology, we used to say the dose makes the poison. So the higher the level of a chemical, the more toxic it would get. But now we know with a lot of chemicals such as phthalates that they can actually have significant health impacts at very low doses.
We're exposed to multiple phthalates in the environment, and these need to be eliminated as a class. What I mean by that is we don't want to just eliminate one phthalate and replace it with another. We want to eliminate people's exposures to all phthalates.
Food and Drug Administration has allowed 28 phthalates to be used in food contact materials and food contact articles. And that's why food is a significant source of exposure.
If we want to protect vulnerable populations in our society at large, then we need to remove phthalates from the food system.